Draupadi Murmu took oath as the 15th president of the country on July 25th. She is the first president of the country who was born in independent India. She is the first tribal person and the youngest person to hold the highest office of the country at the age of 64. She hails from Uparbeda, a small village in Mayurbhanj district of Odisha. From a four-room village house with a thatched roof to the 340-room Rashtrapati Bhavan, her journey has truly been inspiring. From today, her new address is going to be the Raisina Hills. Notably, India's presidential palace, that is Rashtrapati Bhavan, is the second largest official presidential home in the world. Italy's presidential palace, the Palazzo Montecitorio, is at number one. Draupadi Murmu will henceforth be referred to as Madam President. Murmu, who once lived in a mud house, will now be living in the biggest house in the country. Rashtrapati Bhavan is so huge that if the president wants, she can choose to stay in a new room every day. Surprisingly, despite all the grandeur, Murmu will be reportedly staying in a guest room in the presidential palace. As per reports, she will complete her 5 years tenure by staying in that guest room. One must be wondering why this is so. To understand this, it is important to go back around a century to understand how the foundation of Rashtrapati Bhavan was laid. Back in 1911, when the British felt the need to move the country's capital from Kolkata, then Calcutta, to Delhi, the need of a luxurious residence emerged for the Viceroy to reside in. Back then, there was a hilltop near Raisina village, and the responsibility of designing the place was given to the eminent architect Edwin Lutyens. He designed the place in the shape of the English alphabet H. It was supposed to be constructed within 4 years, but eventually the construction took 17 long years. 70 crore bricks and 30 lakh stones were used to construct this imposing and grand edifice. This governor's abode was later chosen to be the official presidential accommodation, and C. Rajagopalachari, the first and the last governor general of independent India, became its first occupant. But he was a man of simple taste and he did not like this luxurious accommodation. He then zeroed upon a room in the guest house in this building to stay during his tenure. On 26th Jan of 1950, Dr. Rajendra Prasad became the president and the name of this governor's house was changed to Rashtrapati Bhavan. Dr. Prasad also chose to stay in the same room in the guest house. Since then, it has become a tradition for the presidents of India to stay in this room in the guest house, which is referred as the family wing. Draupadi Murmu will be following the same tradition that has become a symbol for the simplicity of occupant of the highest office of the country amidst the grandeur of this place.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.